paper is about measurement of bound and pore water T1 relaxation times in cortical bone using three-dimensional ultra-short echo time cones, 3D UTE cones, sequences. First, we will talk about the backbone. Bone has a hierarchy structure, including Haversian canal with blood vessels and fluid, lacuna canaliculi systems with bone water filled in. Bone is a composite material with about 42% mineral by volume, 35% collagen, and 23% water. Mineral is responsible for bone stiffness and strength. Collagen is responsible for deductibility and energy absorption, while water is responsible for viscoelasticity and poroelasticity. Bone quantity is typically measured with bone mineral density, or BMD. Bone quality is determined by many factors, including microstructure, porosity, organic matrix, bone water, perfusion, etc. BMD is used in the diagnosis of osteoporosis with T-score less than minus 2.5. BMD is measured by DXA, which cannot assess the organic matrix in water. Those two together occupy 67% of bone by volume, but this information is completely ignored by DXA due to technical limitations. Meanwhile, BMD accounts for 60% of bone strength. BMD alone has only 30 to 50% success rate in detecting bone fracture. Furthermore, vertebral fractures are weakly associated with BMD. It is very important to consider contribution from bone water and organic matrix. Bone water accounts for 15 to 20% of bone by volume. As mentioned earlier, water provides poroelasticity and viscoelastic properties of bone. Water provides a medium for flow and bone formation. It is very important to measure bound water, a biomarker of organic matrix, and pore water, a biomarker of cortical porosity, including their T1, T2 relaxation times and volume concentration. Bone water exists in different forms, including water in the pores with longer T2 but still short T2 star, about a few milliseconds. Bone water bound to the organic matrix, which has T2 of a few hundred microseconds. Collagen protons have extremely short T2 of around 10 microseconds. The purpose of this study is to utilize the efficient 3D cone sequences for fast volumetric measures of T1 BW and T1 PW of cortical bone in vitro and in vivo, to compare 2D UTE and 3D cone sequences on a rubber phantom and ex vivo bovine bone samples, to apply the 3D cones techniques to healthy volunteers on a 3T scanner to demonstrate the feasibility of fast volumetric assessment of T1 BW and T1 PW in vivo. Materials and methods. Here shows the 2D non-slice selective UTE and 3D UTE cone sequences, as well as sampling trajectories for 2D UTE and 3D cones. Both 2D UTE and 3D cones sequences employ a short rectangular pulse duration equal 26 to 52 microseconds for signal excitation, followed by single or dual echo radial ramp sampling. Magnetization preparation, including short 90 degree saturation plus duration equals 2.48 microseconds, and long adiabatic inversion pulse duration equal 8.64 milliseconds, can be applied before UTE data acquisitions. UTE detects signal from both pore water with a longer T2 star and bound water with a shorter T2 star. Bicomponent analysis of UTE signal decay can be used to measure their T2 stars and relative fractions. IR UTE can selectively invert and null signal from pore water, leaving bound water being selectively detected. Bound water T2 star can be measured with single component fitting of IR UTE signal decay. The effect of T1 of bone water, including both bound and pore water, can be measured with UTE acquisitions with variable TRs based on this equation. Poor water T1 can be measured with similar technique, but a longer TR, 2.4 milliseconds or 2.5 milliseconds, when bound water signal decays to near zero, and only poor water signal contribute to the UTE signal. So a dual echo variable TR-UTE acquisition would provide information on effective T1 and poor water T1. We know that IR-UTE sequence provides signal from bound water only, as described by this equation. Here, Q is a factor describing the efficiency of adiabatic inversion for long T2 tissues such as muscle and fat. Q approximates 1 for bound water with very short T2 star of around 0.3 milliseconds. Q approximates O, or full saturation. So the IR-UTE signal equation can be simplified to this equation. Bound water T1 can be measured by exponential fitting of IR-UTE signal with different TR-T1 combinations on the condition that each TR-T1 combination satisfies the inversion and nulling of poor water magnetization. A brief summary of the T1 measurement techniques. Dual echo UTE allows measurement of effective T1 and poor water T1, while IR-UTE allows measure of bound water T1. The same for T2 star. UTE bicomponent analysis allows measurements of bound and poor water T2 stars and their relative fractions. Single component fitting of IR-UTE images allows measurement of bound water T2 star. First, we investigated 8 bovine cortical bone and eraser phantoms, which were stored in phonbolin to minimize dehydration and air tissue susceptibility. Here shows the T2 star bicomponent analysis protocol, with 15 TEs ranging from 8 or 32 microseconds to 10 milliseconds, taking 6 minutes for 2D UTE and 19 minutes for 3D UTE. For T2 star of bound water, the same 15 TEs were required, but with IR-UTE sequences. This slide shows the T1 measurement protocol. To measure effective T1, we investigated 3 approaches: 2D saturation recovery, UTE with saturation recovery time of 7 to 800 milliseconds; 2D dual echo UTE with variable TR of 14 to 700 milliseconds; and 3D dual echo UTE with TR of 6 to 200 milliseconds. Poor water T1 was measured with a longer TE of 2.5 milliseconds. Bound water T1 was measured with 2D and 3D IR UTE sequences with 5 TR TI combinations. TI may be slightly changed according to the measured poor water T1. About 6 minutes for 2D and 10 minutes for 3D measurements. For in vivo TI measurement of 8 volunteers, we used 3D dual echo UTE with variable TRs of 7.8, 11, 15, 20, and 30 minutes, with 2 TEs of 32 microseconds and 2.5 milliseconds. The total scan time is 14 minutes for effective T1 and poor water T1 measurements. We use 3D IR UTE with 5 TR TI combinations to measure bound water T1. The total scan time is about 11 minutes. About results. This slide shows typical 3D UTE imaging of tibia and femur of healthy volunteers. This is rubber eraser. Bone shows little contrast. IR-UTE shows excellent contrast. Reprojection of the 3D data in the oblique coronal plan again shows nicely rubber and bone, including tibia and femur. Another example of 3D UTE cones imaging of the upper leg and forearm. Again, excellent contrast for cortical bone, even the thin cortical bone in the femoral neck. This slide shows selected images of a bovine cortical bone sample acquired with 2D dual echo saturation recovery, UTE, with a TSR of 100 milliseconds. TEs of 8 microseconds, A, and 2.5 milliseconds, B, 2D dual echo UTE with a TR of 100 milliseconds, and TEs of 8 microseconds, C, 2.5 milliseconds, D, 3D dual echo cones with a TR of 20 microseconds, sorry, milliseconds, and TEs of 8 microseconds, E, 2.5 milliseconds, F, both 2D UTE and 3D cones show similar bicomponents, T star, T2 star, decay for cortical bone, bound water with a shorter T2 star of 0.26 to 0.27 milliseconds, and poor water with a longer T2 star of 2.40 to 3.11 milliseconds, and single component 2T star, decay for rubber, single component exponential recovery, curving or curve fitting shows a 2-1 TW of 264 plus 30 milliseconds, J, a T1 PW of 586 plus 24 milliseconds, K, and a T1 rubber of 193 plus 6 milliseconds, L, with the SR UTE approach, a T1 TW of 207 plus 6 milliseconds. M, a T1 PW of 548 plus 8 milliseconds. N, and a T1 rubber of 185 plus 4 milliseconds. O, with the UTE VTR approach, and a T1 TW of 193 plus 5 milliseconds. P, a T1 PW of 521 plus 15 milliseconds. Q, and a T1 rubber of 166 plus 3 milliseconds. R. This slide shows 2D IR UTE imaging of a bovine cortical bone sample with a series of TR T1 combinations of 400, 164 milliseconds. A, 300, 129 milliseconds. B, 291 milliseconds. C, 148 milliseconds. D, 50, 24 milliseconds. E, and 3D IR cones imaging with the same TI combinations of 400, 164 milliseconds, F, 300, 129 milliseconds, G, 291 milliseconds, H, 148 milliseconds, I, 50, 24 milliseconds, and J. Excellent single component fitting of images acquired with different TEs was achieved for cortical bone with a T2 star BW of 0.25 plus 0.01 milliseconds derived from 2D IR UTE images K and a 2T star BW of 0.26 plus 0.01 milliseconds derived from 3D IR cones images L. Exponential fitting of images acquired with different TRTI combinations was achieved for cortical bone with a T1 BW of 113 plus 10 milliseconds derived from 2D IR UTE images M and a T1 BW of 119 plus 9 milliseconds derived from 3D IR cones images N. Representative 3D dual echo cones, VTR imaging of the tibial midshaft of a 33-year-old healthy volunteer with a TR of 15 milliseconds, dual TEs of 32 microseconds, A, 2.5 milliseconds, B, 2.5 milliseconds scan time, as well as 3D IR cones imaging with a TR of 200 milliseconds and a TI of 90 milliseconds in 2D minute scan times. C, single component exponential recovery curve fitting of dual echo 3D cones images and variable TRs show a T1 TW of 273 plus 13 milliseconds D, and a T1 PW of 518 plus 36 milliseconds. While fitting IR cones, images with variable TR-TI combination shows a T1 BW of 126 plus 8 milliseconds F for cortical bone. Table 1 measurement of T1s of pore water, T1 PW, bound water, T1 W, and total water, T1 TW, in bovine cortical bone, N equals 8. Using 2D non-selective saturation recovery, UTE, SR-UTE, 2D UTE with variable TRs, 2D IR UTE with variable TRs, and TI combinations, 3D UTE single echo cones with variable TRs, 3D dual echo cones with variable TRs, and 3D IR cones with variable TR and TI combinations, respectively. T1 TW, T1 PW, and T1 BW values reported in the literature are also listed for comparison. Table 2 measurement of the T1s of pore water, T1 PW, bound water, T1 BW, and total water, T1 TW, in tibial midshaft of healthy volunteers, N equals 8, using 3D dual echo cones with variable TRs and 3D IR cones with variable TR and TI combinations, respectively. In summary, we demonstrated that 1. The dual echo variable TR 3D cone sequence produced similar results compared with the non-selective 2D UTE sequence using both dual echo TSR and variable TR techniques for the quantification of total and bound water. For T1 measurements of bound water, the IR techniques using the 3D cone sequence yielding a mean measurement of 144 milliseconds compared with 116 milliseconds obtained using the 2D UTE sequence. This may be due to the differences in spatial resolution, echo times, and sampling window. The 2D UTE sequence with shorter echo time and sampling window is more efficient in capturing signal from a larger proportion of the rapidly decaying bound water component. Furthermore, the 2D UTE sequence is non-slice selective. B1 variation across the specimen thickness, 6 centimeters, will also affect T1 measurements. The FAST 3D cone sequences provide additional opportunities for quantification of T1s of bound and pore water in cortical bone. There are several limitations. First, a single component model was used for T1 calculation of total water, which is only an approximation. Multi-component analysis would be helpful to elucidate the fractions of T1 values of the bound and free water pools, 22. However, the accuracy of multi-component fitting is dependent on the quality of data, including SNR, number of sampling points, of echo times, and separation of relaxation times. The 3D cone sequence may be well suited for multi-component modeling, and this deserves additional study. Second, errors in T1 PW measurements would lead to imperfect nulling of pore water, resulting in long T2 signal combinations in IR-UTE imaging of bound water, and thus errors in T1 BW estimation using the IR cones acquisitions with variable TR and TI combinations. Third, flip angle errors were not considered in the TI quantification in this study. B1 mapping or actual flip angle imaging, AFI, techniques would likely improve the accuracy of T1 TW, T1 PW, and T1 BW measurements, 39. Fourth, mapping of bound and pore water concentrations were not performed in this study. With T2 star and T1 values of both bound and pore water components known, accurate measurements of their absolute concentrations can be easily achieved through comparison of bone signal with that of a reference phantom with known proton density. Validation studies as well as clinical applications of total bound and pore water mapping will be performed in future studies. Thank you.